Hi, I'm Hector, and welcome to another video tutorial by Soundgrains. In today's video, we'll take a look at adding reverbs and delays in a session. Reverbs and delays are classified as time-based effects and are added to a track using auxiliary sends. They are also known as aux sends. Reverbs are used to create a sense of space and to help individual instruments blend together in the mix, while delays are generally used as creative effects in the mix. In today's session, we have a simple drum track. We'll be adding some reverb and delay to this drum track. Let's take a listen to the track. On the track that you wish to add reverb to, we'll use the snare. Left-click on the empty send and select New Track. This will allow us to create a new aux track to place the reverb or delay plugin on. This track will be known as the Effects Return track. We'll choose to create a stereo, aux input track, in samples. Pro Tools has automatically created a new bus called Reverb, which routes to our new aux input track, which is also named Reverb. This is known as our Reverb Return track. Place the Reverb plugin on the insert of the Reverb aux input track. For this video, we'll use the Deverb plugin, which can be found under Multi-Channel Plugins, Reverb, Deverb. To add reverb to a track, we simply need to send some audio to the reverb bus, which will be processed by the reverb plugin. The output of the reverb plugin will be mixed into the main mix via the reverb return track. The processed signal is known as the wet signal. The original unprocessed track is known as the dry signal. To increase the amount of reverb in the track, we increase the send level to increase the level of the wet signal. Command left-click on the left side of the send to show the mini send level fader. The mini send level fader allows us to easily access the send level of all tracks. Bring up the fader for the snare to increase the amount of reverb for the snare. We can now hear the reverb added to the snare. Everything sounds fine at the moment, but if we try to solo the snare track, we hear that the reverb return gets muted as well. This makes it inconvenient for us to audition our reverb with the snare. We can fix this by using the solo save function in Pro Tools. To solo save the reverb return track, command left click on the solo button on the reverb return track. The solo button will be disabled, and the return track will no longer be muted when we solo another track. To send another track to the reverb plugin, we can simply duplicate the send to another track. Hold down Option, left click, and drag the existing send on the snare track to the hi-hat track. Alternatively, you can click on the empty send, go to Tracks, and select the reverb return track. Creating a delay effect is identical to a process we have done for the reverb. Simply replace the reverb plugin with a delay plugin of your choice. I'll use the Mod Delay 3 for this example. Now that you understand how to add reverb and delays to your mix, I hope you'll have fun using them in your mixes. Leave a like if you like this video, or leave a comment below telling us why. Subscribe to the channel to not miss out on any new videos by clicking on the subscribe button. Watch one of our other videos to learn more about music production. Help us to make better content for you by telling us what you want to learn next. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and I'll see you next time.